Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. If you've not already done so, we suggest that you watch the videos on plate tectonics, igneous rocks, and sedimentary rocks before watching this video. This is the Capitol Building in Washington, D.C. Like so many other historic buildings and sculptures, much of it is made of marble. Marble has been a favorite choice of architects and sculptors for thousands of years because it is attractive and relatively easy to work with. Marble is an example of a metamorphic rock. In this video, we'll introduce what metamorphic rocks are and how they're made. Many of us first hear the word metamorphosis when we learn how caterpillars change their forms to become butterflies. In geology, we also use the same word root. Rocks that have changed their forms are called metamorphic rocks. This is the sedimentary rock called sandstone. In the prior video, we learned that when layers of sand are compacted and cemented, sand becomes sandstone. Under the right conditions, sandstone will change into quartzite during a process called metamorphism. What do you think the variables are that make the right conditions? To learn what variables turn sandstone into quartzite, let's find some sandstone and quartzite. The Grand Canyon has been covered by sand on multiple occasions, which formed a lot of sandstone. In this photo, we see sandstone at the top. Near the bottom, we find quartzite. Here's a side view that shows us some layers. When we add the height of each layer, there is more than 3,500 feet of rock above the quartzite. That is more than twice the height of our country's tallest skyscraper. That means the quartzite is under very high pressure. And before it was turned to quartzite, the sandstone that was here was also under very high pressure. This tells us that one of the variables needed for metamorphism is pressure. Another variable is temperature. The temperature underground gets hotter as we go deeper below the Earth's surface. The temperature range for metamorphism is similar to what we use for cooking, typically about 500 to 2000 degrees Fahrenheit. The low end is like an oven, and the top end is like a butane torch. If the temperature gets hotter than 2000 degrees Fahrenheit, the rock melts into liquid magma so is no longer a rock, and then there will be no metamorphism. Another variable is time. During metamorphism, the crystals inside the original rock are being grouped together, rearranged, and some are regrown entirely. Making crystals is a slow process. To summarize, the major metamorphism variables to change one rock into another one are 1. The minerals and chemicals in and around the rock. In the first example, we started with sandstone, but we will show several other examples. 2. Pressure. 3. Temperature. And 4. Time. One way to remember these variables is to think of cooking with a pressure cooker. The metamorphic rock is like the final food that comes out of a pressure cooker. The major variables in cooking and metamorphism are the same except for the word ingredients. In geology, we use the words minerals or chemicals instead of the word ingredients. Now let's look at the sedimentary rock called limestone. We know it started as shells which were compacted and cemented to form limestone. When limestone undergoes metamorphism, it becomes marble. In nature, we find marble in mountains, like in this quarry. Why do you think we find marble in mountains? The answer is because when mountains are forming, the land is squeezed under very high pressure, and the weight of mountains several miles tall can also make a lot of pressure on the rocks far below the peaks. As mountains are made, there is also high temperatures inside them. And since mountains form over a long time, that means the conditions are present for metamorphism. We know that limestone forms from seashells that sink to the bottom of oceans or seas, so it may seem strange that limestone rock would become part of a mountain range. To understand this, let's look at the land that is now the Rocky Mountains. Before the Rocky Mountains were formed, much of what we call the western U.S. was under a sea. We know this because we have found seashells like this in many places, including the Grand Canyon. As the Rocky Mountains were made, that limestone changed into marble. Most limestone, and the marble it becomes, are made of calcite crystals. Calcite is the third mineral on the Mohs hardness scale. The reason limestone and marble are different rocks despite being made of the same crystals is because during metamorphism, the tiny crystals in limestone are grouped together and organized into larger crystals. The crystals in limestone are too small to see, but we can see them in marble. Larger and better organized crystals often make metamorphic rock harder than the one it changed from, but not always. For example, quartzite is about 3 times as strong as sandstone. In contrast, marble is similar in strength to limestone and may even crack more easily if it contains black stripes like these, which are called veins. These veins are impurities and not made of calcite crystals. Marble tiles or blocks may crack along these veins. Next, let's look at what happens to the sedimentary rock called shale when it undergoes metamorphism. Shale forms when layers of mud on the bottom of lakes or other bodies of water gets compacted and cemented. With mildly increased pressure and temperature, that shale turns into slate during metamorphism. You may have seen slate used as a sign in a restaurant. In some countries, slate has also been a popular shingle on homes for many years. But if shale is put under even higher pressure and temperatures, it will keep changing into different rocks. Unless your teacher indicates otherwise, for middle school, you don't need to know any of the details on the following slides. The learning objectives are 1. Some original rocks, like shale, can change into many different rocks. And 2. Metamorphism can happen on metamorphic rocks. This slide tells us that once shale has been turned into slate, that slate will turn into a different rock called phyllite if the slate is put under this pressure and temperature. If that phyllite is then put under even higher pressure and temperature, it changes to schist. If that schist is then put under even higher pressure and temperature, it changes to gneiss. If that gneiss is then put under even higher pressure and temperature, it changes to migmatite. A pressure of 174,000 pounds per square inch would be equal to the entire weight of this plane concentrated on an area the size of a quarter. Next, let's look at what happens to an igneous rock under metamorphic conditions. As we learned in the video on igneous rocks, basalt is made from lava that slowly cools. Basalt can turn into many different metamorphic rocks depending on how much pressure and how much temperature it is exposed to. These are just a few examples. You can see several of these rocks have wavy lines. Unlike the lines in sedimentary rocks, lines in metamorphic rocks are often curved and in alternating colors. To summarize, some rocks like these limestone pillars and sandstone only change into a few types of metamorphic rocks regardless of the metamorphic conditions they are exposed to, whereas other rocks like shale and basalt can change into many types of metamorphic rocks. Metamorphism can happen to igneous rocks like the basalt in this arch, as well as to sedimentary rocks and to metamorphic rocks. Our last topic is to discuss 4 events that can cause the conditions needed for metamorphism. We already discussed the first 2 earlier in this video. The first event is by being buried deep below other rocks. We saw this in the Grand Canyon when learning how sandstone changes to quartzite. The second event is being inside a growing mountain. We saw this when learning about marble. This is happening right now in the world's tallest mountain, Mount Everest, since it is still growing. There are 2 other events which can create high pressures and temperatures that we discussed in videos earlier in this series. Which events do you think they are? The third event is being in a subduction zone, which is when the rocks of an oceanic crust in one tectonic plate slide under the rocks of a continental crust in another tectonic plate. The rocks that are sliding against each other are changing their forms. And the fourth event is when a rock is near hot magma or lava. For example, when there is a crack in the Earth's crust, hot magma comes up from the mantle to form an igneous intrusion. The sedimentary rock around that hot magma will then change into a metamorphic rock. Here's an example of the 4th event. After there were many layers of sedimentary rock made, an igneous intrusion formed deep below the surface. That magma heated up sedimentary rock that was close by and turned the sedimentary rock into metamorphic rock. Many years later, when everything has cooled down and a lot of surrounding rocks and dirt are gone, now we can see all 3 of the rock types together. Once a rock undergoes metamorphism and changes to another rock, that rock will not revert back to its earlier version. For example, this marble sculpture will not change back into limestone. Here's a summary of the topic we just covered. Please pause the video to read this if you wish. Please subscribe if you'd like to be notified of future educational videos we make. Thanks for your attention.